All right, folks, before we get started on the main video here, this is kind of the debrief because it didn't really go according to plan exactly. We started off here at trailhead number 2 on the Lone Star hiking trail out in the Sam Houston National Forest. Our goal was to end up down here, kind of in this area somewhere for camping. They've been doing some cutting in here for logging, or not logging, fire breaks for controlled burns, stuff like that, but basically forest management stuff. We ended up getting off onto one of those instead of on the trail proper, and ended up cutting out over here because we eventually realized that it wasn't the proper trail. Got to the road, followed this Forest Service road down, ended up camping where we intended to camp, and then followed back through on the trail on the way out. Pretty short hike. It's just a one-nighter. We got there Friday afternoon, left Sunday midday, or not Sunday midday, Saturday midday. So not even 24 hours in, just kind of a fun thing and opportunity to play around with the night vision. So hope you guys enjoy it, and let's get to the trail. Hey folks, we're out here today for a weekend trip in Sam Houston National Forest. This is my buddy Matt. He's going to be coming along with me using the buddy system. Hopefully we'll get you some good footage of stuff going on around camp, and also after dark some playing around with the night vision and assorted electronics to go with that. So check it out. And we're definitely in Southeast Texas, even though it's only April. Look at how dense the undergrowth is. We actually lost the trail for a little while, had to detour to find a Forest Service road, but it eventually tied back into it, so we're back on the good path again. We might camp here in just a little bit, so check back in with you. Well, dusk is starting to fall on us a little bit, so I think we're going to set up camp here. We're at a little primitive camp area that is off to the side of the trail. Pretty serious undergrowth still, but there's a few spots here where we can set up at. There's another group a little ways down from us there, a couple other guys. Someone here didn't do a cold out fire. This is actually, you can see it still smoldering, so not sure when they left, but it's still definitely a fire hazard, so not good. All right, and we got those other folks' fire lit again. We got my little setup over here. Got the rain cover on just kind of loosely in case it rains on us tonight. There's a little bit of a chance of it, but probably just end up leaving it open like that for most of the night. Matt's got himself his little, can I show you? His little setup over here. There we go. Kind of same situation. Guess we'll get the stove out, cook a little bit of dinner, and play with the night vision after that. See you in a second. And not much to see here. Just got the little Trangia stove and a Esbit little stainless steel flat pack tri-stand thing. Just boiling up some water, making some mac and cheese. Do a little bit of chili mac for dinner tonight. Well, I got too distracted making dinner. I forgot to take a video of making dinner until right now, so. There's some chili mac, not the lightest weight meal for something like this, but since it's only one night, it's not too bad. Tastes good. All right, folks, and now we're looking through the night vision. I'm sitting here in camp because I've got this in front of the camera, so it's hard to move around with it. You can kind of see the remnants of the fire right there in front of us. Let me see if I can demonstrate this thing kind of upside down. Where's my... I can demonstrate the built-in illuminator on the PVS-14. See it there. Doesn't really do much for you. It helps a little bit close up here, but we've got a full moon tonight, so it doesn't really do too terribly much at all to help in addition to the really nice lighting that we've got. You can see that I can turn the gain down, and I can turn the gain up to get it really kind of too bright, especially for tonight. I've usually been running it, I guess, about right here as I've been playing around. To me, that's about perfect.
you might be seeing a little bit of flashing. That flashing is, if I can find it in the dark, one of these little strobes here. Ooh, that's bright. One of these strobes, and I've just got it sitting on my pack in the tent. That way, as I'm moving around in the woods here, playing with it, when it's on my head, I can make sure I find my way back, so I don't get lost. What else do I have here that I can show you? I've got the, this is the Streamlight Sidewinder Compact 2. And, okay, there it is on, and it's low power IR, second, third, fourth. So there's the brightest. And you can see it does maybe a little bit better than the built-in illuminator on the PVS-14, but not much different. And then the, that's off, and then on a little bit. It's pretty dim, but nice little. Let's see if I can adjust it to see. Yeah. Nice little utility light. I've been using as a white light, just clipped to my hat for most of the evening, just cooking and things like that. Works out really well. Handy, takes either a CR123 or a AA or a AAA. So really handy. Does also red light and blue light. Red light and blue light, IR and white. So pretty versatile little around the camp kind of light. And now, actually, I guess I should have zoomed back closer to me, huh? Let's see. Can I show you this here? You're seeing some reflection from the strobe behind me. So we got the Steiner D-Ball D2. See if I can put my hand in the way of that strobe. Steiner D-Ball D2. Let's look at its features. Flip it over to, I believe the first setting is the laser. Focus back out. We'll have to go actually pretty far out for this. Yeah, I'm a little bit past. I don't know exactly where I am. Back out there. So there's the laser. It only has one power of IR laser. On the visible setting, it has two different power modes, a low and a high. But that's the laser. I'm gonna try not to shine it up in the air or anything because I don't know what's up there flying over me, but. And then go to, so there's a spotlight. And that thing is, it is really, really intense, as you can see. Really intense. And this I should be fine to shine up in the trees. But I mean, you could probably illuminate hundreds of yards out with that illuminator. I mean, it is really, really potent. Really too much up close, which is kind of unfortunate. And then, I think the other one was a low power mode, and then this is the high power, and then this is high power, I believe, with laser, but I really can't tell, because it is so bright. That's definitely going to low power mode there for the illuminator, but just really intense on how bright that is. Is that a possum or something? Not sure. Can I see it? I thought I saw something moving around in here. But I guess not, because I don't see it now. And see, this thing almost works better as a secondary, like, splashback kind of illumination. Like pointing it near something that you want to see. Because if you point directly on something, it just washes it out. But let's go ahead and Got a mosquito bugging me. Let's go ahead and just while we're here, I'm gonna try not to fall walking around with this thing. And you see Matt there enjoying the beautiful full moon that we got tonight. Really kind of nice out. Let's see if I can walk along here without falling down, just to give you guys a little kind of trail walk in the dark. And we're not really on the main trail here. We're kind of at a little pull off where you can get a little flat spot to set up a tent. See, I'm tripping on stuff. Pretty cool, huh? I mean, I don't think it's too bad. Let's look back at the camp. You can see the embers of the fire there from earlier. And that's not visible at all to the naked eye. Even up close, I can't see it. And I certainly can't see it from here. Obviously, I can't see that strobe. I can vaguely, in the moonlight, make out the outline of that tent. Very vaguely. I mean, I can tell there's something there. Like, I mean, I might think it was just a change in elevation. But obviously with the night vision, how you guys are looking at it, you can see it quite clearly and even see inside of it. See Matt sitting over there. I can see his tent a little bit better because it's a lighter color, but still wouldn't be able to make out exactly what the object is. But with the night vision, it's pretty clear. Let's see if we can go on up this way a little bit further. A lot of moonlight tonight, kind of cool. In a second here, when we run back to camp, I think I might take the phone out of the little mount that's showing this to you guys and see if I can see anything at all with the plain phone. Okay, that's a fern. See, I can't hardly tell what that is, even with this full moon. And part of it's probably that I'm staring at this phone screen. My night vision of my own eyes is kind of trash because of that. But, you know, just even through the phone like this, it's actually helping me navigate quite a bit. Looking over here, there's some pretty thick growth around. And this area that you're looking through right there, to my eyes, that's just a dark hole. I mean, I can't see that there's actually kind of a path there, but to the naked eye, totally invisible. Pretty thick undergrowth. And this is actually one of the clearer areas. We were walking through some real bad stuff earlier today. But let's get on back to the camp. And we should be able to see. Can we see the strobe? Oh, there it is. Make our way back that direction. Oops. I'm walking pretty slowly because I don't want to trip and fall out here and land on a stick or something. That kind of ruined the day, wouldn't it? With it on my head, I can walk a fair bit faster than this, but it is still... I mean, it's not like being in daylight. You have to watch your step a little bit more and just kind of be careful. But now that we've made it back to camp here, let me go ahead and shut this off and show you guys what it looks like through the camera, at least, without the night vision. So, time to go dark. And so here's what you can see without the night vision. And I don't think it quite does justice to it. It doesn't actually look this dark, but probably not. Well, you can actually see quite a bit more with your naked eye, but just to give you a comparison from what the phone sees versus what the night vision through the phone sees. Here's my red light. think that's all, folks. Let's get to sleep and see what the morning brings us. Have a good one. Sleep tight.
All right, folks, it's a good morning. About 8 a.m. now. We've already broken camp. Got our fire coaled out and cleaned up a little bit of the mess that some of those other people had left with some foil and things, but we're good and cold out here. Kind of a nice day. A little bit cool. I'm not sure exactly what temperature it is, but nice and green. A few birds singing. Hit the trail, and I think we're going to have breakfast when we get back, more towards the vehicle. But let's get moving. It's a nice morning. Matt's taking the lead for a little while with a stick. See if we can not walk into a spider web. Doing a great job up there with that. Then we got just some Southeast Texas. That's what it looks like. Miles and miles of it. Focus, but there it is. That's gross, isn't it? Big old spider. Got him a June bug or something. Nasty. All right, something kind of interesting to see. Here's the trail where we're on and where we just came from. If you look right next to the trail here, they got a little temporary road cut in, a little fire break road. It appears they've done a controlled burn over here next to the trail. You see some of the char marks on the trees, the lack of remaining flammable vegetation and stuff. Getting eaten by mosquitoes here, but yeah, something interesting to see there. They've been doing a burn in the area. A little footbridge here. Kind of nice. All right, we made it back to the parking area. I think we decided to forego breakfast. We got a bag of beef jerky here, courtesy of the Kroger company. So I think that's gonna be breakfast. We're just gonna start heading back to our side of town. So thanks for watching, folks. If you enjoyed it, like and subscribe. Hope you like the night vision stuff and the spiders and all that stuff. So have a good one. We'll see you next time. Bye.